G'day Blues fans, and welcome to House Brothers Oval for another edition of Blue Tube In and Under. Today we've got former club captain and club stalwart Benny Nelson here. Now Benny, you've just come back from injury the last few weeks. Obviously the last couple of games wouldn't have been, I guess, too much fun for you going down to both North and the Bays. But you personally, how are you finding, you know, coming back into footy? Is the body good? And secondly, as far as where the club sits at this point in the year, are you happy or otherwise?
Yeah, a few questions there, Rhino. Mates, the hip's feeling really good now. You know, surgery back in December, so it took me a while to recover. It's about a three-month process. We knew we'd be behind the eight ball a little bit, but, you know, got some good conditioning with Danny Boubaris, a fair bit of one-on-one stuff through February and March. About round six, I think it was, started my first twos game. Played three there with a lot of the younger blokes, and that was a great experience just to get them to know them a little bit better and try and find a bit of form. I was pretty average early, but it slowly got better as time progressed. And then to come back into that team that the first game back this year was against Central, so that was a sensational win. And then to back that up with two pretty bad losses over the last 2 weeks, it was complete contrast. So look, where we're at the moment, I think, you know, we're travelling all right. You know, we do have to work on a few areas, which Luke identified, you know, leading into the bye last week. And sometimes you just got to get back to the simple things, and we were doing them really well early. And whether we got away from that, it's hard to put our finger on it. But we come up against Westies at Wakery, so, you know, different scenario. You're on a bus 2.5 hours, so we'll prepare. You know, we'll have to prepare mentally as well as physically for that game. And they've just knocked off Norwood, so it'll be a great challenge for us, mate.
Well, I was just saying to Luke, to Ben, I guess the next 4 weeks are probably what you would term as pretty winnable games for the club. If we can get through the next 4 weeks, we've had a pretty rough last 3 weeks with, you know, a few games in 11 days. We can get through the next four, we really set ourselves up for some finals footy.
Yeah, we knew it would be a really tough month. We had, you know, we were backing up after 5 days and then 6 days and against good quality opposition. We've set a new goal now for the next 4 weeks, and we've freshened up, and the bollocks will be that keen to get into it this week after the weekend off. So, yeah, West, Eagles, South and Port, I think it is, so maybe not in that order. But, you know, all winnable games, but, you know, quality opposition. If you drop your guard against those guys, you know, you see Port beat North on the weekend and West Norwood. So we've just got to make sure that, you know, we address each game, and Westies this week, and then but we do set a four-week block that, you know, if we're going to finish top three, we really need to win, you know, all four games.
And mate, I told you I was going to ask you this question, but there's a few boys around the club that seem to think that you are the practical jokester of the club. Apparently go around playing a few practical jokes on the boys and this sort of thing. Now, I know you're denying it, yeah. So perhaps, mate, if it isn't you, who is it, mate? Now, who do you want to tip in that is actually the practical jokester? Who is the idiot around the club?
The idiot? Mate, I think they just think I'm a practical joker because I'm about 10 years older than half of them. But, look, there's always a bit of banter floating around and always keen to get involved in any sort of jokes that are flying around. But, there's a blend of blokes that always have a bit to say. Fish, Macca, Scooter McGlone's not bad on the tongue. Sheeds will chip in every now and again.
Apparently,
and then
Gummy's not too bad either.
Gummy's always good, very sharp. And then you've got your younger blokes that are just, you know, McDonald, Yench, Anderson, pretty quick-witted as well.
So, and mate, is there anyone around the club that's usually the butt of these jokes? Is there anyone who's a bit of a, you know, who cops it more often than not than others? A bit of an easy target.
No one that we ever really hammer, but
you don't single anyone out and cut one from the herd, maybe?
Mate, it used to be Sarge Perry last year. He was the easiest target going around ever, but I'm not off the top of my head. I'll have to get back to you on that one, right,
mate? No worries. Well, thanks very much to Ben Nelson for joining us on YouTube here tonight, and go you Blues.